And we're getting ready for our main event, and what a fight we are expecting. Rustam Nurmagomedov taking on Denis Shafikov. The winner of this fight will be the number one contender in the lightweight division for the IBF. The tail of the tape, you can see that Nurmagomedov has a 5-inch height advantage, but Shafikov with a 1/2-inch reach advantage. Very interesting. Here's the top 10 in the IBF right now, in case you were wondering. 1 and 2, not ranked, the champion, Miguel Vasquez. There's Nurmagomedov at number 5. Denis Shafikov actually just fought Miguel Vasquez in his last fight, losing by unanimous decision. But if he wins tonight, it appears those two would be fighting again. And here is Shafikov. Freddie Roach will be in his corner handling cuts tonight. He's 29 years old, out of Russia, only has one professional loss, that coming in his last bout to Miguel Vasquez. And there is Rustam Nurmagomedov, one of our favorites here on Friday Night Fights, known as the Mongoose. He's won 6 consecutive bouts, including 5 knockouts in his last 5 fights. He's coming on strong with a professional record of 27-6-1. You mentioned that you've seen him on Friday Night Fights. Well, here's some of the damage you've seen him inflicted. Knockout after knockout, there's one. And here's the Peruvian, Jonathan Micello, with a straight right hand to his face, and that was all she wrote. He would go down and not get up. So the Russian destroyer, Rustam Nurmagomedov, looking to win tonight to put himself in whatever every fighter dreams of, that being a title opportunity. He's confident, he's ready. So what do these two fighters have to do to be successful? That's not for me to say. Let's send it to Teddy Atlas, who's enjoying the finer things in life, for this week's fight plan.
They play polo over here, the sport of kings. It used to be the sport of kings. Kings aren't quite what they used to be, but right here, tonight, we're gonna do the fight plan. Get a chance to find out who will wear the crown someday. No mallets, no horses, just fists and legs and plenty of aggression. Both these guys like to come forward. I'm gonna be Nurmagomedov, Shafikov. Well, Nurmagomedov, well, let's get right to it. He likes to get inside in the trenches and he likes to put water in the basement. Both sides, bang, bang, and then upstairs, bang. Take those legs away so there's nowhere to go. Where he has them right where he wants them. Otherwise, his only choice, go get a horse. All right, now how does Shafikov get the best of it in the trenches? Well, first of all, he's a southpaw. And this field, you see how wide it is? Well, that's how wide the stance of Nurmagomedov gets on the inside. Wide and square. What does that mean? It means he gives you a lot of surface to hit. And Shafikov, well, he can get inside, split the guard. Right up the middle with his power punch, the left uppercut, bang! But Nurmagomedov has a real good chin, so don't stop there. Bang, bang! Put those two right on top of it. If you do that, there's nothing else to do except maybe a little spot of tea and a little polo. A little polo, that's the key word. More like crochet. Okay.
I wanted you to get on that horse so bad. Used to have power to knock out a horse, I heard, in both hands.
You didn't want to see me get on a horse as badly as I didn't want to get on a horse.
Have you ever ridden a horse?
And I've never knocked out a horse, by the way, either. I'm not Mumbo from, what was the name of it? From Blazing Saddles.
Okay.
Mumbo.
They're billing this as
Alex Karras, actually. Oh. Remember? Alex Karras,
a little before my time.
Well, okay,
but I remember him knocking the horse out.
You're right, he knocked the horse out.
Yeah.
On TV.
I gave you both instructions in the dressing room. I just want to remind you, listen and obey my commands at all time. Protect yourself at all time. Good luck. Fight hard, fight clean.
Teddy, they have billed this as the slugfest in Santa Ynez. Is that what we're going to see? A true old school slugfest.
Somewhere along the line, yes, you're going to see that. You got the right, one of the right referees in there, Jack Reese. He does
Ready?
A great job. He won't interrupt
Ready?
The action. He'll watch it, he'll control it, but he won't mess it up like some referees nowadays will. But look, there's options here. The shorter man, here's the funny thing. Here's the twist. I'm going to tell you right now. The shorter man, in this case, obviously, Shapovalov, you think he's going to go forward. He's going to try to box a little bit. I mean, most people thought he was going to go forward. I talked about it in the fight plan, but I can't do everything on a fight plan. I can pick one thing. Somewhere along the line, he's going to go in the trenches. But I think that early on, you're going to see Shapovalov, as you've seen it right now, he's going to try to box a little bit. He's going to try to get the guy up to give up his height a little bit, go in and out, use his legs to keep Nagaev, who's a machine, who just keeps coming forward, keep more balance a little bit. But somewhere along the line, they're going to wind up inside saying hello to each other. And we're going to like that.
Well, 7 years ago, they said hello to each other. In fact, they lived together for a brief time while training in Los Angeles, both fighters from Russia, so they know each other well. This is the first time, though, they've fought as professionals. Nagaev wearing the black trunks with gold trim, Shapovalov in the solid white. Shapovalov, a 5-inch height advantage, but enjoys a half-inch reach advantage. A bit strange.
Yeah, if he uses that reach. So again, here's the funny thing again. You have Nagaev, who's the taller guy, a lot taller, longer, but he likes to get inside. You know, he likes to eat in the patio, you know, right there. He doesn't like to eat outside on the terrace. And so he's going to be trying to get inside. He might be giving up that height a little bit, not using it in a way that he could use it. And that's where Shapovalov's boxing comes in a little bit. Nagaev's just looking to get inside, then Shapovalov can box. And then he can win rounds. Then he can have a good night. But if Nagaev decides to use that jab, guess what? It's going to force the hand of Shapovalov, where Shapovalov's going to have to get inside.
Nobody punch.
Because if that jab is being used, that height is being used by Nagaev, well, it's going to be very hard for Shapovalov to stay to this plan. Boxing. Very hard.
We asked Shapovalov what his game plan was going to be, and he said, we know we're faster than him, so we want to outspeed him and outwork him. But, Teddy, you know it's hard to outwork Nagaev, who never seems to stop coming forward. Shapovalov coming off his first professional loss against Miguel Vasquez. The Mongoose Nagaev has won 6 consecutive fights, including 5 in a row by knockout. This one could go either way. And by that, I mean it could be a knockout in the second round or could go the entire 12 rounds.
Stop.
And since it is a title eliminator, it is scheduled for 12.
What I didn't like a minute ago was Nagaev gave up the height, fell in a little bit. When you fall in, that's what happens. The shorter man can out-hustle you a little bit.
Time.
Welcome back into the Shumash Casino. This is our main event, wearing the black and gold trim. It's Rustam Nagaev taking on Denis Shafikov in the solid white. The winner of this fight will be the mandatory challenger at 135 pounds in the IBF lightweight division.
You know, Shapovalov is a bigger guy. I think a lot bigger. You know, and I wonder if it'll be the difference with a guy like Nagaev, who likes to get inside and be physical, because Shapovalov, he's between welterweight and junior welterweight most of his career, mostly junior welterweight, really his entire career. He only dropped down to lightweight his last 4 fights, while Nagaev, well, he's been a lightweight and only a lightweight his entire career. He went up to junior welterweight only in his last fight. So the bigger guy, even though he's a smaller guy, the bigger guy is Shapovalov. So if he has to go inside, he's got no problem with that extra size, that extra bulk, maybe the bigger skeleton, really the bigger bones. He has no problems going inside. So maybe Nagaev really needs to do both, win inside and win outside. Now Nagaev's getting to where he likes to be.
Nagaev had Shapovalov back against the ropes momentarily.
Yeah, but Shapovalov showed you his fight plan there. You know, a lot of times in his career, he would have stayed there, but he decided to use his legs and get out of there. So, again.
Stop. Separate.
You know, my instincts,
box.
I guess, you know, my thoughts were so far right that Shapovalov, even though he's a short guy, that a lot of people thought it was just going to come forward, he's coming here to box tonight, at least early on. And that's what he's doing.
Seems like Shapovalov willing to take a couple punches and then springs back to life to fight back.
Well, what really he's doing, it's not that he's taking punches, he's using his legs to keep Nagaev off balance so Nagaev can't come back. That's what he's doing right now. He's getting in, he's getting out, he's getting around Nagaev, keeping him off balance. Nagaev is a punching machine when you let him get going. And one way to keep a punching machine from going, keep him off balance. And that's what Shakaev, or Shavakov, I should say, that's really what he's doing right now.
Shavakov with 90 amateur fights. Said he didn't like fighting as an amateur. Said he needed to earn money, not medals. Tonight, he can earn a lot of money if he can win and become the number one contender again.
Well, so far, he's winning against Nagaev. And again, he's got a little quicker hands. He's using those legs to keep Nagaev off balance. Nagaev's really got to go to that body. That's the key for me. If the corner's not telling him that, they better tell him that. Because that's the best way to slow those legs down of Shavakov. If they're going to win, they're going to have to take the legs away from Shavakov.
Left hand there to end round number two. Another good round for Denis Shavakov. Here's our top 10 from the transitional rankings in the lightweight
transnational
division. Transnational, excuse me. And as you can see, Teddy, neither Nagaev or Shavakov is ranked, and yet they will be getting, one of them, a title opportunity in the IBF. Your thoughts?
Well, my thoughts are that transnational are the only ones I believe, the only ones I go by. I gotta be honest with you, I don't know why we even watch or we show IBF or WBC or WBA. I know tonight we did it because IBF, that's exactly what this fight is, and we wanted to show where they were in the IBF. But other than that, really, I don't think we should be showing any other rankings. And what I just showed there, what we just showed there is simple. Transnational rankings, they have a higher standard. That's why they're not rated. They haven't quite gotten there yet. They're stricter about when they put their rankings behind the fighter. And it's not anything to do with relationships with a promoter or with a manager or with an organization. It's purely about what the fighter has done. So for me, that's it. Transnational rankings are the only ones I really want to see and I want to believe.
Round three now of a scheduled 12. Rustam Nagaev, once the bell rang, went running over to Shavakov. Knows perhaps the first two rounds didn't go his way. But you know, last time Nagaev fought here on Friday Night Fights, he was losing on your scorecard to Marvin Quintero before Quintero seemed to hurt his hand. So Nagaev got off to a slow start there, but look at these punches exchanged here.
Yeah, but that's a different, you know, you're comparing apples and oranges, quite honestly. Quintero, you know, a different level of fighter than Shavakov. Shavakov's not going to submit. He's not going to evaporate like a puddle on a hot summer day when the pressure starts to come. It's going to be up to Nagaev to give more pressure than Shavakov and to go to the body again. He's got to go to the body, take some of those legs away, take some of the steam out of Shavakov.
And a big shot connects there by Shavakov, and Nagaev forced to stand straight up. Here comes some of that slugging that we were hoping
JD,
for.
I got a cut.
It comes courtesy of Shavakov.
You know, Shavakov had a technical decision from a head clash. He had a head clash in his last fight. He was cut off his right eye. He's got scar tissue. I wouldn't be surprised if that scar tissue started to open, because both these guys are in there with their heads. Again, Shavakov over the right eye has scar tissue. I noticed it before. Been involved in head clashes before.
We've got blood right now. It appears to be coming off the bridge of the nose of Nagaev as Shavakov continues to target that bloody area.
Again, I wonder if Nagaev is starting to wonder if he chose the wrong way to go. I said it at the beginning. He could go on the outside and score with his jab, make it more of a boxing match, make it difficult for Shavakov to box and pick his spots, neutralize Shavakov on the outside. But as I thought, he went to what he likes, what he's comfortable with. The guy of just going inside, just walking inside and wanting to get into the pit, into the trenches. The only thing is, Shavakov's not making it easy for him. He's timing him on the way in. He's giving a little ground, he's doing that, he's pot-shotting him a little bit, and then he's moving just a little bit to keep him offset. In other words, what I'm saying is both guys are tough. Shavakov's a little smarter. That's what I'm saying right now.
It may come down to who's tougher. And now Nagaev landing a couple of punches as Shavakov tried to move his head down left and right.
I'm going to tell you what the late great Customato said to me, my mentor, when he said about being tougher. When both guys are tough, the guy who's smarter, he's tougher. And right now, that's Shavakov.
Another solid round for Shavakov as both men get their shots in.
I talked about in the fight plan, look for the uppercut on the inside by Salvo. Goes, yes, I said the left. Okay, but here's the right uppercut, splitting the guard. Why? What were we said in the fight plan? The guy covers up, puts those earmuffs on, he squares up, gives you a lot of service, gives you a chance to split that guard. Exactly what Shafikov did.
Round four of a scheduled 12 again. The winner gets a shot at Miguel Vasquez, or so it would seem. He's the current title holder in the IBF. There's our punch statistics in the last round. Look at all those punches thrown, Teddy.
Yeah, well, we said that it would be a fun one, and it's gonna be a fun one. It is a fun one. Plenty of action.
Cut from a headbutt. Excellent.
Cut from a headbutt. You just heard Jack Reese say, cut from a headbutt. I talked about in the first round that Shafikov has been involved in a technical decision from a head clash. He had a head clash in his last fight.
Stop.
He was cut off his right eye in his last fight.
And cut from a butt box.
There it is. Cut
from a butt.
From a butt. No buts about it. And that would be Nagaev being cut.
Nagaev promised that this would be an all-out war, and it would be an all-out war that he would win. He's at least half right so far, as again, both Russians tee off on each other against the ropes.
Well, Nagaev is ready for a rough fight. He came in the lightest in 3.5 years that he's been. I'm wondering if he did too much in the gym. This fight means everything to him. I wonder if he is too light, or he's just in great shape. I guess we're gonna find out.
Shafikov has already had a title opportunity. Nagaev has not. It's a dream come true. It's why they are in the United States. Shafikov said the U.S. is the center of the boxing universe. I need to be in this country. I need to win in this country. And that's why he's here on Friday Night Fights.
And the reason why not only people are here, but the reason why Shafikov is winning, well, he's boxing. You got the slugger, the guy who has the option of boxing on the outside with the long jab. But this is what he likes to do. He likes to get inside, and he likes to bang away. And Shafikov taking advantage when he comes in. Giving up a little ground, setting traps, countering a little bit, giving back a little bit, blocking a little bit, and moving when he has to. Again, tough both guys. Smarter guys so far, Shafikov taking advantage of the aggression. He's taking the aggression, the strength of Nagaev. That's usually his strength. He's taking it and he's spitting it right back at him.
The buzz is beginning to build here inside the Somala showroom. Perhaps something special on the horizon. The first three rounds and change have been extremely exciting, entertaining, particularly the last couple of rounds. Almost like when you're boiling water, it takes a few minutes to get it going, the steam rising up. And that's what's happening now, as both fighters appear to be very comfortable and are just throwing punch after punch.
You need a good corner man. You need somebody who sees things you don't see. Someone has to tell the guy if you gotta go to the body when you get inside. Take those legs away.
Time.
We talked about Shafikov being involved in head clashes before. He propels himself, falls in there, head gets ahead of his legs. Watch, upper body gets ahead of his lower body, and he bangs that head. Take another look, propels himself, bang. The head goes right into the side, the left side of Nagaev.
He got cut.
Nagaev gets cut.
And you heard our referee, Jack Reese, calling out that the cut was caused by a headbutt, but look at the damage done to the face so far of Rustam Nagaev. He does not look too pretty right now.
Again, it's the boxer versus the slugger. Could have went a lot of ways. My instincts told me as this fight started, Shafikov's gonna box. His instincts, his intelligence was right to do that so far. And this can be neutralized, I say it again. If Nagaev would use that wingspan, he's much taller, much longer. Use that jab to take the boxing away from Shafikov, to force Shafikov to only be aggressive. But Nagaev not doing that. This is what Nagaev does. He just walks in. And he's getting outsmarted. He's getting outmaneuvered right now with the legs.
Now look at Nagaev saying, bring it on. This is what Nagaev wants. All out action.
I disagree. It's not what he wants, because he's getting the worst of the action. He's getting caught too many of those shots. What he does want, to your point, is for Shafikov to lay there in front, not to use his legs. That's what he wants. For him to lay in front of him too long, where Nagaev can get something off and do some damage. But Shafikov is too experienced to fall into that trap.
Let's look at Teddy's scorecard through four rounds, all of them going to Shafikov. We invite you to score on our Friday Night Fights Facebook page. You as well have it 4-0.
Get in the corner. Somebody needs to start telling Mr. Nagaya, you better start using that jab. Control the outside a little bit, because you're just walking in, you get caught on the way in, and you're doing nothing to keep the little man from doing that. Come in and go out.
Shafikov now forcing Nagaya to put up those earmuffs and tuck in those elbows to protect his body. And you mentioned the corner. Let us not forget Freddie Roach is also in the corner.
But he's not the man training Shafikov. He's in there as the cut man, the man training him, the man that's responsible for this fight plan. Let's give him credit. Ernie Zavala in the corner of Shafikov. The big name is Freddie Roach, I get it. But the man who set up this fight plan that's working so well so far for Shafikov, Ernie Zavala.
Shafikov, if one can look comfortable coming off the ropes, taking a few shots, looks quite comfortable.
He's not comfortable. He's acting like a pro and he's not showing. Nobody is comfortable getting hit punches. Let me tell you that right now, Todd.
Look at how he answers back, though. Still has a pep in his step, but taking some shots here from Nagaev, who's working inside with some uppercuts.
Uppercuts, and again, Nagaev, what the doctor ordered, he's got to go downstairs to the body. Got to start taking those legs, some of the wind out of the sail of the guy who really is sailing round after round, and that's Shafikov.
Nice counter punch there from Shafikov.
Stop. Nobody punch. Step back clean.
That is the canvas. Denis Shafikov has been the artist so far in this Russian versus Russian encounter, our main event on Friday Night Fights. Rustam Nagaev wearing the black trunks with gold trim, Shafikov in all white. The winner of this gets an IBF title fight, presumably against Miguel Vasquez. Teddy, what did you think about the way the corner was treating Nagaev this past round?
I didn't think they were using the head swelling up, to be quite honest with you. They're swelling on the left eye of Nagaev. That's going to get worse and worse. It's going to impair his vision. You need that cold piece of metal. That's the end swell you're talking about. You need that to be used on the eye. I saw it in the hand of the man in the corner, but not applied where it needed to be applied. But now some blood in the corner. You see the blood leaking in the corner of the right eye now of Shafikov.
So both men have been cut. Both are bleeding. Shafikov appears to be doing quite well in this fight as far as the scoring goes, but never count out Nagaev, who will not stop coming forward.
No, both guys tough, but again, one guy tough and smart. That's Shafikov. He's tougher right now. And one of the problems for Nagaev, you know, he blocks up, you know, he goes into that peekaboo, but he doesn't move his head really. He moves it from too far away sometimes. But then when he gets close, he just covers up. And when you just cover up, well, Shafikov knows what to do. He puts them together.
Nagaev swinging wildly with a couple of punches as Shafikov counters and hits inside.
No body work in there by Nagaev. That's missing. That's one of the reasons why he's not slowing down Shafikov. He's not going to the body. We see the legs. You know, we see the hands. That's the easiest thing to see, Todd. Look, we see both guys laying their hands or trying to lay their hands on each other. What we miss is the legs. See the legs? Shafikov, that's the difference in this fight. The legs of Shafikov.
Nagaev said he'd been working and training on cutting off the ring, but apparently, at least according to Teddy Atlas, he's giving too much surface to hit. He's been too square in this fight.
Well, look at his legs inside. Look how wide they are, Nagaev.
Oh, and a nice left hand, rights and lefts now, as Shafikov is starting to turn it on here.
Yeah, you know why? Because the legs are too wide. A lot of surface to hit for Shafikov with those wide legs of Nagaev, and Nagaev couldn't adjust. He couldn't adjust. He couldn't move when Shafikov moved.
Some unanswered punches now, as Nagaev is simply not firing back like he used to. Shafikov connecting here. 13 seconds to go in round number 6.
Big round for Shafikov. Big heart is keeping Nagaev in it.
Time.
You understand?
Welcome back here to Santa Ynez. The doctor just checked on Rustam Nukhayov. They say he's still good to go, Teddy.
Yeah, well, they were looking at him. They're looking at the eye, obviously.
And you're not throwing it today? Why can't you throw it tonight? Huh? Why can't you not throw it tonight? Huh?
I laid out there because I wanted you to be able to hear Rudy Hernandez, the trainer of Nukhayov, but the doctor, one thing I saw, the doctor went in there, did the right thing, looked at the eye, but it took him about 20 seconds. That 20 seconds that were taken away from working on the eye by the corner man of Nukhayov. They couldn't put the N12 while the doctor was looking at his eye. See, I'm a believer that when you have to do something like that, it's the right thing, don't get me wrong. But when the doctor has to spend time looking at a fighter like that, give him the time back. Give him that 20 seconds back. Extend the corner, extend the rest period where now he can work and do the work he needed to do that was taken away from him by the doctor looking at him.
Shafikov with a fight high, 42 punches landed in round six. He's been faster, he's been more precise.
Because look, besides the eye having to be dealt with to Nukhayov, he has to be
step away from each other,
rejuvenated a little bit. He needs cold water poured on his head, he needs to drink some water, you know. He needs to be taken care of in that way. And that wasn't done in the corner. Again, the doctor's doing the right thing. He's looking at the eye in the corner of Nukhayov, but stop the corner men from doing their job for 20, 25 seconds. I believe that 20, 25 seconds should be given back in that case to the corner, to the fighter, so they can do the job they couldn't do.
Round six may have been Shafikov's best round. And Teddy, if your scorecard is any indication of what the judges are seeing right now, Nukhayov may need a knockout.
Yeah, he probably does, or at least start getting some knockdowns. And that's not going to happen too easily with a guy with the experience of Shafikov, who's 33-1-1. I mean, that's not going to happen too easily. His only loss was for the world title. And it's not going to happen if Nukhayov doesn't go to the body. This is only the second fight out of 36 now that Shafikov has fought here in the United States. He has really, look, he's fought in Russia, Finland, Latvia, Mexico, China. I mean, this guy is really, truly a global warrior.
His fight in China was for the championship of the division against Miguel Vasquez, the only blemish on Shafikov's record. He'd love to have another crack at Miguel. There's no more for running, sticking, and moving, not the traditional Mexican style of fighting.
I'll tell you again, what's winning this fight is the legs, up and down, downstairs, upstairs. I mean, Shafikov is just dominating, giving a beating, old-fashioned whooping to Nukhayov. And part of it is legs, and a big part of it, I've said it many times, he has more dimensions, more options. Nukhayov, one option. Walk straight forward, and that's been taken away. That's been dealt with by just a more dimensional, smarter Shafikov.
Oh, and a left hand connects, and once again, the bell's coming at the perfect time for Rustam Nukhayov.
Stop.
All right, take a look here on the right side in the box. It's live. Left side, replay, and that's a bad replay if you're Mr. Nukhayov. He just got hit a big left hand just before the bell.
Jack Reese, the referee, telling Nukhayov's corner, listen, guys, I'm not going to watch much more of this. The end is near. So that's the mindset of the referee. The mindset of Nukhayov has to be, do I have enough power left to end this with a big shot?
No, he doesn't. Not with a headshot. He's got to start with the body. I mean, that's his forte. That's his Sunday punch, if you will. And that's what's been missing all night long. And that's why Shafikov has been a difficult target for him, because he's used his legs. He's been allowed to use those tires. Plenty of air in the tires of Shafikov, because, well, Nukhayov just hasn't punctured them. And the way you puncture them, you go downstairs.
And how frustrating must it be that every time Nukhayov lets his hands go, Shafikov answers with a perfectly timed counterpunch.
And Shafikov 2 years younger. That helps a little bit. Right now it's helping. It's all helping.
Shafikov said he was going to be faster, would use his speed to his advantage, would outwork him. And so far, the game plan has worked brilliantly. Shafikov, perhaps a couple rounds away, maybe even sooner, than getting yet another title shot in the lightweight division. Good 1-2 there from Shafikov. Blood continues to stream out of the nose. Nukaev as well as a cut. Both men are cut, in fact.
You keep walking straight in the door when you have a guy ready for you, like Shafikov is.
Stop. Nobody
you're going to have blood streaming, believe me. Keep walking in that front door. You don't go in the side door. You don't do anything to trick Shafikov. You're right there. You're available. Shafikov has been taking advantage of that predictability all night long.
Let each other go. Stop. Break.
Straight up to the body, Dennis. Straight up. Work.
You can hear that body shot connect, and there's Nukaev with the left hand, and it's Shafikov right on the chin. But the power just doesn't seem to be there for Nukaev. The one punch power we've seen in the past. After getting beat down for 7+ rounds, I'm sure it saps a lot of your strength.
See, I never looked at him as a one punch guy. I gotta be honest with you, Nagaev. To me, it was all about accumulation. That was his strength, that he wore you down. And it was about body punching. And that hasn't been there tonight.
Time.
We're gonna keep it here. Let's listen into the corner of Rustam Nagaev.
Sit down.
Get him. Get him. Him. Somebody. Go!
Rustam, everywhere to me, this fight is over. But Edward refuses to stop this fight. What do you say? Huh?
Continue.
Continue? For what, Rustam? For what?
Mike.
You still have a chance?
Rudy.
Huh? Do you have a chance?
I call time again, one more
do you
time.
Have, do you have a chance?
Look at the side of that cheek, what's going on behind it, brother. You tell me, you guys tell
talk
me.
Talk to him.
Look at that cheek. There's a lot going
talk
on behind
him.
He's been taking punishment for round after round after
yeah,
round.
Yeah, keep up, Rustam.
There's no such thing as the last round. As soon as he can't protect himself, we're done. You understand? You hear what I'm saying? He's taking heavy shots on the
gun. I say stop.
Okay?
That's your shots on my head.
All right?
You're calm, Edward. I say you stop it.
What are you going to do? No. No, okay.
That's Rudy Hernandez, the trainer.
What's not?
He wants it stopped.
It's not good.
He's asking to manage it.
You can't.
The manager said no.
You got to. You got to.
Manager.
Move your head from side to side. You go to the body and then you
trainer
come
wants
to
it stop.
Let those uppercuts go.
The trainer's the one who knows chance. Most, knows best.
I mean, really?
You want to not the manager.
What do you think, Rudy?
Huh? What? What do you tell me?
Yeah. Huh?
You will go.
Okay.
The guy, I believe, said one more. So
yeah,
here we
you
go.
Ask a fighter. Look, if you're going to ask a fighter, if you're going to depend on asking a fighter, if it's a real fighter, and the guy was a real fighter, he's not gonna say. Hey, take me out of here. He's going to say, carry me out on my shield. That is the mantra. That's the attitude of a fighter. Sometimes someone else has to make that decision. Just like Eddie Futz did years ago in that great fight, the Thrill of Manila with Ali and Frazier. Eddie Futz in that 14th round, you know, that back in the days when it was 4-15 rounds instead of 12, he made the decision to stop that fight.
This isn't just a normal fight. Nukaev with a chance at a title if he can somehow, some way, find a way back in this fight. It's the biggest fight of his life. He's not going to quit. Someone's going to have to quit for him.
This is going to be the last round unless something very, very, a bolt of lightning from the sky or maybe a big punch, as I like to say, some water in the basement. Maybe a punch not in the sky. Maybe downstairs comes. But something dramatic and unlikely is going to happen.
And that body punch back Nukaev off. And we may just be seconds away. And there it is. The referee says enough is enough. And there's your victor, Dennis Shafikov, who will get yet another title opportunity in the IBF lightweight division.
Well, we said someone has to make the decision, and somebody did. The referee, Jack Reese.
Let me get out. Let me get in. Stay up.
Here you go.
We got nothing to do. We got nowhere to go now. You understand? We got nowhere to go.
No, you see, something's going on behind that cheek.
Okay, I understand.
Thank you.
Tonight,
Tonight wasn't your night, you understand? It wasn't your night.
You know what that reminds me of?
You fought very brave. Let me tell you something. But you're around to go again, okay?
So he's swallowing blood.
We can fight again.
I see it now.
Okay? We can fight again.
I think you're right. Maybe the first
I would have stopped at one more round before. There's no reason to go back.
He was getting counter.
Teddy, here's the body shot that spelled the beginning of the end, at least in this round.
Yeah, it was the right hook. A couple of shots upstairs just to set it up, and then downstairs, and then again downstairs. But it was an earlier body shot first that really did the damage. Upstairs, bang, downstairs. See, the upstairs punches, they get the elbows to move to go upstairs. That's how smart guys like Shavakov are. And then he gets the opening downstairs.
We've been critical of referees in the past, Vic Darchinian a couple of weeks ago, but how about the fantastic job Jack Reese did tonight in there? Gave Nugaev every opportunity to continue on. He knew how big this fight was, but in the end, stopped it at what I believe was the perfect moment.
Yeah, I believe it too, and we were talking about it.
His cheek is broken, and his mouth is open, swallowing blood.
You understand?
Yeah, he did the right thing, and that's why you just heard him saying why he stopped it. Jack Reese, those were his words. And that's why I said before the fight started that we had the right referee in there for this kind of fight.
Let's get the particulars now. We send it into the ring, and Mark Lichtenfeld.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Jack Reese halts this contest at 1:16 of the ninth round. Your winner by technical knockout, and now the IBF mandatory lightweight world title challenger, Denis Shapovalov.
It was a slugfest, but most of the slugging came from one side of the ring, that being Denis Shapovalov. Friday Night Fights, presented by Corona Extra, returns in a moment. ESPN Friday Night Fights is presented by Corona Extra, who invites you to find your beach, and in part by One A Day Men's 50 Plus Healthy Advantage. There are plenty to choose from, but let's take a look at tonight's foolproof Punch of the Night, brought to you by Just For Men.
Big left hand. First, he makes a miss, makes him reach a little bit, creates the opening. That's how you do it. Make a guy miss, you make him pay, and Shavakov did quite a bit of that tonight.
So Rustam Nugaev has been featured on Friday Night Fights several times. Teddy, I know how much you like him. What does the future now hold for him after this setback?
He might never be the same fighter. I mean, after taking a beating like that, mentally, confidence-wise, you know, physically, obviously, he's 31. Yeah, 31 years old. I mean, you take a beating like that, you might never be the same fighter, because everything was built on you being a boss. You weren't the boss tonight.
Well, you heard his corner tell him there'll be other fights for us. Don't give up. Don't hang your head. But I'm sure you, as well as our viewers at home, know this was the biggest fight of his life, and it just was not meant to be. Denis Shapovalov will get a title opportunity and not Rustam Nugaev. So let's take a look at the damage that was done. Look at Nugaev's cheek. The referee, Jack Reese, said, hey, enough is enough. I can't watch this anymore. He's busted up. When we return, we'll head back to Bristol to put a bow on tonight's proceedings.